Welcome back to our Intro to Flow Cytometry series. In our previous videos, we looked at the fluidics and the optics of a flow cytometry system. In case you missed this, you can check out the link in the description. In today's episode, we're going to be looking at how your light signals gets translated into data that the computer can read, also known as the detection system. Let's take a look. In a standard flow cytometry system, the detection is usually done by photomultiplier tubes or photodiodes. We're not going to go into the exact physics of how these work today. All I want you to know is that these take your light signals, the photons, and convert them into an electronic signal that the computer can read. In the flow cytometry world, this signal that we're looking at is called the voltage pulse. Inside the detection system, as a cell starts to pass through the laser, we'll start to see the collection of photoelectrons over time. As the cell goes further into the laser, this will peak and then drop off as the cell exits. So essentially, that's the voltage pulse, just looking at the collection of photoelectrons on the detector over time. Every voltage pulse will have an associated height, area, and width, represented by H for height, A for area, or W for width. When you look at the axis of your flow cytometry plots, you'll see this label there. When you look at your fluorescence data, you'll notice that some cells have a low level of fluorescence, and some cells might have a high level of fluorescence. This can be translated directly back to the voltage pulse. So a cell with a low level of fluorescence will have a lower voltage pulse than a cell with more fluorescence, which will have a higher voltage pulse. So this is how we can then start to discriminate the difference between cells with a low level of fluorescence or a higher level of fluorescence. As you've seen, the voltage pulse for a single cell is a nice bell-shaped curve. Where the cell enters the laser, you see signal, it peaks, drops, and the cell leaves again. While this is useful for looking at fluorescence levels, we can also use the voltage pulse for discriminating single cells from doublets, or two cells stuck together. We do this by looking at forward scatter area versus forward scatter height. In a flow cytometer that's been properly set up, these single cells should have an equal ratio between area and height, so the cells will fall on a 45 degree angle on this plot. Imagine a scenario where you have two cells stuck together now passing through the laser. And imagine what the voltage pulse for this might look like. So you know that a voltage pulse for a single cell is that nice bell-shaped curve. So when you have a doublet, what you actually end up with is the start of that bell-shaped curve as the first cell goes through, then it drops off a little, but then the second cell comes through, so it peaks again, and then drops off. As you can see on this cartoon plot, the doublets have a similar forward scatter height to the single cells, but a shift in the area. So they're no longer on that nice 45 degree angle where you find the single cells, making them fairly easy to gate out. Now, while this is all well and good to look at happy faces and circles, it's really easy to see there. Translating this to a real forward scatter, side scatter plot, you can see a nice distribution of the single cells along that 45 degree axis, and a shift in the doublets below that axis. And that brings us to the end of our journey as a cell through a flow cytometer. To recap, your cells will be in your sample and taken up into the instrument through the fluidic system. Here, they're put into the flow cell where they're hydrodynamically focused by the sheath. In the flow cell is where they also intersect with the lasers. The lasers then activate the fluorochromes, resulting in fluorescence emission. These fluorescent signals are sent through a series of filters where the light is then directed to the detection system. In the detection system, the photons are digitized into a voltage pulse that can be read by the computer, resulting in the appearance of your data. Thanks for joining us in this portion of the Intro to Flow Cytometry course. Our next videos will look at the more practical aspect of setting up your experiments. This will cover things like selecting controls, choosing fluorochromes, and how to set up voltages on your instruments. So make sure you hit that subscribe button and click the little bell icon so you don't miss out on any of the fun. And with that, we'll see you in the next one.